relationship between you guys, or the dysfunctional relationship between you guys, is really heating up as the series goes on. Are you enjoying playing that dynamic together?
Yeah, it's really hot. The only thing I regret is when Hermione worked at Pops as a waitress, I really wanted Alice to come in and just give it to her, just make her order really, just really rub it in her face, but, you know, she's moved on to other jobs, so whatever.
Well, you could still show up there.
Yeah.
There's still a chance.
Don't limit yourself.
I guess I could show up. That's true.
So what was your knowledge of Archie to begin with, and how do you think this new Archie attracts a new generation of fans?
I knew Archie from, honestly, Gum Wrappers, from Bazooka Joe, where you'd take open the gum and it'd be Archie Betty or Robin. I was like, oh, cool. I didn't realize how long the comic book had been around, mm-hmm. for so long, and new iterations of it and all of that. And then when I heard that they were making a show, I was like, oh, that's cool. But I didn't think I'd have anything to do with it. Yeah. And then, honestly, when I went in, Roberto, who you'll meet, he sold me on the show. His passion for it, and how he explained how he was going to do it, and dark, and this, and that, and what they were going to do with the adult characters. I was like, that's a show I will watch. So I'm in.
I have to say that I'll admit that I was a little skeptical how they might bring it to life, because you always worry a little bit, like when they bring sort of an animated thing to life, how they're going to do it. But you know, once again, Roberto was so impressive and so passionate, and had such good. He grounded the characters and made them so relevant that I thought it was brilliant, and I was super excited to play. And his ideas for Alice, I just was like, yep, sign me up.
I love how they're gradually feeding us information on the backstories, especially of the parents. Are we going to learn a lot more by the end of the season on both of you guys?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Anything you can tease?
I'm teasing that this one's got a major reveal towards the end of the season, which I was shocked by.
I was too.
And then just we're going to find more of Alice Cooper's history and why she acts the way she does. She's got a lot of drama and a lot of history that I think
Yeah, we do.
You start to,
And you understand Alice a lot better, and I think Hermione just confuses everybody better.
Yeah. And that's the thing. It's right? Like, the more we understand Alice Cooper and why she does what she was, all of a sudden we're thrown to, like, wait a minute, Hermione, what?
I know.
It's fun.
So, Hermione's big reveal, then, that's coming up in the future episode, is this from her past while she was in Riverdale, or is it from fine when she was in New York?
This brings everything that you've heard so far as New York, Hiram, prison, what you've seen, what you've heard of, like, she's trying to turn over a new leaf. You're going to see a lot of the old Hermione and how she got to where she was married to this powerful man. Come full circle, is what I can say. It's so hard to explain without it.
I know.
But it's good. It's like she said. I was like, what? And I was like, does this work? Okay, cool.
Yeah. The T's kind of changed the dynamic between Hermione and Veronica.
Speaking of dynamic change, last night's episode, Betty and her mom, is that going to be a turning point? Like, how is their relationship going to change now that...
Yeah, that was a big turning point for them. And I think that you start to realize that, you know, there are times when Betty is the adult in the relationship. And I think we've all gone through that with our parents, you know, there's those moments of like you're being parented, and all of a sudden you have to step up and be there for your parent. There's a lot that gets revealed, and I think you feel for Alice a little bit more the more you understand her history and why she is the way she is. I think it's a turning point. It was a really fun episode.
So do the scripts really shock you?
Yes. I forget what one, there was one in particular that from that point forward, it was just like, it was like a roller coaster. It was
for me, it was 12 and 13, 100%.
Yeah, literally the actors were flush in the room doing the table read, like, whoo, this is intense.
Yeah.
So it was fun.
Now, both of your characters survived season 1, so we do know that somebody does. ultimately not continue on for season two? What would you like to see for your characters in season two?
I'm really rooting for Alice to unbutton her shirt a little bit and maybe have like a wild night out. Maybe with girls, maybe with a guy. I'm just saying. And have to do like the there's maybe, I have an idea.
Huh.
Maybe Alice could have like a night fling with Jughead's dad.
It's where, just, where did you get that?
I don't know.
Could Hermione be watching her when she does the walk of shame?
Yes.
Can Betty be waiting on the couch looking at her watch, like, where have you been?
Mom, as she like stumbles in with one heel.
For Hermione, I doubt this is gonna happen, but if I had it my way, she would finally put Hiram in his place, tear that down, take over her family, and do what she really wants to just do and be. But I doubt that.